Hello, my name is Saocain, and this time let's take a look at the Cottontail Eagle Eye Outlander. As always, I will talk about abilities, commander, team, class, support perks, gadgets, pros and cons, and after that I will rate this build. Cottontail Eagle Eye has Phase Shift, the main ability to do damage, Shock Tower, and Mighty Teddy. Her commander perk, Unexpected Departure Plus, will leave 3 egg bombs after using Phase Shift, which deal 55 base damage to nearby enemies. I am using Shifting Gears team perk, and this perk gives me additional Phase Shift charges and decreases range. I am using this team perk because I want to have a lot of Phase Shift charges, so this way I can spawn a lot of eggs. Cottontail Eagle Eye Outlander has Anti-Material Charge, In the Zone, and Loot Llama class perks. Blue Charge Fragments should decrease cooldown for Teddy and Shock Tower, but this is working strange right now. The first support perk is In and Outlander, and this perk will give you additional Phase Shift charges every time you will eliminate 6 enemies within 10 seconds after using Phase Shift. You need Ambush Buzz if you want to have this perk in your loadout. The second support perk is called Phase Cannon, and description says using Phase Shift causes your next ranged weapon shot to fire a phase pulse, dealing 31 base energy damage and piercing enemies. Switching or holstering weapons removes effect. Field Agent Ryu can give you this perk. The next perk is Phased Out, and this perk decreases Phase Shift cooldown by 25%. You can use this perk if you have Flash AC Outlander. The fourth perk is Phase Siphon. Dashing through enemies with Phase Shift heals 12 base health per enemy passed through. If you want this perk, you need Sanguine Dusk. The last perk is Survivalist, and this perk is a good way to heal yourself when you are eliminating enemies. Survivalist Jones will give you this perk. For this build, I am using Adrenaline Rush and Stationary Hover Turret gadgets. Okay, let's watch gameplay right now, but this time it's different because I was playing on 128 power level zone, and enemies in that zone is level 140. After gameplay, I will talk about pros and cons of this build, and of course I am going to rate it. So, you just watched the gameplay. And you saw how husks almost got me. But they didn't. So, it's time to talk about pros and cons. This build has 7 phase shift charges, so you can move quickly and spawn a lot of eggs. Every egg has explosion radius, and every egg drops in a different spot. So, if there are a lot of husks, they are magically disappearing after using phase shift. Eggs are doing physical damage, so they are most effective against small physical husks and very ineffective against elemental smashers. Phase siphon should heal me every time I am phasing through enemies, but sometimes it doesn't, so it's not very useful for this build at the moment. My rating is a conclusion about this build. So let's talk about it right now. This build is good against swarms of enemies, especially little husks, and it is too weak against elemental mist monsters. So I am giving it 76 points. Adrenaline Rush gadget, Phase Siphon perk, which is not working sometimes, and Survivalist perk. 3 ways to heal without traps. 78 points. This build is easy to play because you don't need to think about buffs of any kind. The only thing you have to do is to learn use phase shift and drop eggs on enemies. 75 points. I have found this build fun to play because it is excellent against weaklings and hordes of enemies in the same area. 83 points. A good thing, you can use every ranged or melee weapon you want. A bad thing, you still have to use weapons. 75 points. Cottontail Eagle Eye is not very powerful, but you can find her fun to play and different from other Outlanders because of the gameplay style. A little bit over 77 points. I hope you will find some useful information about Cottontail Eagle Eye. And if you have some ideas how to improve this build, please let me know in the comments below. Have a good time, take care, and I will see you next time. Bye bye!